Hello everyone. So today we are going to discuss regarding leprosy, which is an infectious disease as well as a communicable disease. So leprosy is a very well-known disease to all of us, as it will infect mostly the skin of our body. So there is a misconception that it only affect the skin, it will affect so several parts of the body. In today's discussion, we are going to discuss the entire aspects which are related to etiology, pathogenesis, symptoms and diagnosis of leprosy. So synonym, that means the other name for leprosy, is nothing but Hansen's disease. So after its identification, so after the causative agent which was caused by this which is causing this leprosy was identified by a scientist called Hansen in 1874, we are calling it as Hansen's disease. And the causative agent is nothing but a very well-known one, Mycobacterium leprae. So this Mycobacterium leprae will affect the cooler parts of the body, such as skin, mouth, respiratory tract, eyes, peripheral nerves, superficial lymph nodes and testes. In advanced cases, we will also observe the damage to the renal system as well as the other organ systems. If you see this Mycobacterium leprae, which is the causative agent for leprosy, it is acid fast in nature. And it will resembles the Mycobacterium tuberculosis. So if you see this Mycobacterium tuberculosis, which is a causative agent for tuberculosis, these two will be similar and they are acid fast in nature. So in tissues, generally it will appear like like in a parallel fashion, like cigarettes in a pack. And so we will observe this Mycobacterium leprae in tissue secretions, split skin smears, cut edges of the dermis and nasal secretions. So if you observe the skin smear of a leprosy patient, so that Mycobacterium leprae will be observed like this. All these brown colored ones are nothing but the Mycobacterium leprae. And the mode of transmission, if you see this mode of transmission, it is a communicable disease with a incubation period of 2 to 20 years, with an average of 3 years. So there is no disease which is having a greater incubation period like this, and it will transmit by the following routes. And so direct contact, it is the most common route of transmission. So those untreated leprosy patient, they will shed so many number of basal lice through their damaged skin, nasal secretions, mucous membranes, as mouth and hair follicles. So whenever if someone inhales those basal lice, so they will get affected by leprosy. And another route of transmission is maternofetal transmission, so through placenta, as well as those individuals who get affected by this leprosy will also shed their bacteria through milk. So transmission from the milk is also one of the common route of transmission. Coming to the pathogenesis of leprosy, we already said, so Mycobacterium tuberculosis is one of the most common bacteria, so which will be shed by various routes from a leprosy infected individual. So whenever it got enters into an uninfected person's respiratory tract, as well as other parts of our body, whatever the squam cells which are present in those cooler parts of our body, so they will try to engulf that Mycobacterium leprae. But so they are unable to kill that Mycobacterium leprae because of the inflammation which was developed against that leprosy bacteria. So squam cells are nothing but our macrophages. So one of the type of macrophages, we will call macrophages by different name based on the tissue where it is present. And whatever the lesions which were happen in case of leprosy, it depends on the cell mediated immunity of that individual who were affected with leprosy. If he is having a good cell mediated immune response, we will observe no skin lesions or nerve lesions, or very rarely we will observe this. And skin or nerve lesions may appear followed by a spontaneous healing, or the individual may develop paucibacillary leprosy. Regarding this paucibacillary leprosy, we will discuss it in our next slides. And whenever the individual is having a very weak immune response, so cell mediated immune response, then we will observe the development of multibacillary leprosy. In addition to the skin and nerves, we will observe the involvement of eyes, testes, kidneys, voluntary or smooth muscles, reticular endothelial system and vascular endothelium. All these will get involved, which results in the formation of disabilities and deformities. So we already said peripheral nerves are the most common ones which will get affected by this Mycobacterium leprae. So whenever this Mycobacterium leprae will go and bind to the peripheral nerves, so our immune system will try to kill that mycobacterium leprae. In order to kill that mycobacterium leprae, our T cells will release so many number of inflammatory mediators as well as cytokines. So while killing that mycobacterium leprae, whatever the myelin sheet which is present on this mycobacterium leprae will also gets damaged, which results in demyelination. So because of that, we will observe so many number of peripheral nerve related symptoms in leprosy. And if you see the classification of leprosy, so generally leprosy will be classified based on the immune response. So if the host offers a lower resistance at the time, it results in tuberculoid leprosy, and if the host offers a greater resistance, we will call it as lepromatous leprosy. So based on the resistance offered by the host, we can classify this leprosy into five different types. One is tuberculoid polar, borderline tuberculoid, mid borderline, borderline lepromatous, and lepromatous polar. And here you can see all those types of leprosies, so which were classified based on the immune response. And we can also classify leprosy based on the cell mediated immune response as pars basilari leprosy and multibacillary leprosy. So pars basilari leprosy will be observed in those individuals who are having good cell mediated immune response, and multibacillary leprosy is observed in those who are having weak immune response. So in pars basilari leprosy, we will observe a localized symptoms, but in case of multibacillary leprosy, we will observe a generalized symptoms. And the bacteriological index in case of pars basilari leprosy will be less than 2, as the individual is having a good immune response when compared to the multibacillary leprosy, where the bacteriological index is greater than 2. And so we will observe presence of peripheral nerve involvement very rarely in case of pars basilari leprosy, but in case of multibacillary leprosy, peripheral nerve involvement will be specific. Coming to the clinical manifestations of this leprosy, so if you see this lepromatous leprosy, skin lesions are symmetrical in nature. All those skin lesions which were happened because of that mycobacterium leprae, so the immune reaction which was developed against that mycobacterium leprae, so because of that immune reaction, we will observe these symptoms, and all those are symmetrical in case of leprosy, so lepromatous leprosy, and they are multiple hypopigmented and erythematous macules, papules, nodules, and diffuse infiltrates will be there. So we will observe blister type of nodules will be observed in case of lepromatous leprosy. And whatever the skin lesions which were developed, they are hypoesthetic or anesthetic in nature because of the peripheral nerve involvement in case of lepromatous leprosy. Even though it is very rare, we will observe hypoesthetic. That means whenever if you touch those skin lesions, they can't feel any. But sensory disturbance is not as distinct as in case of tuberculoid leprosy. But if you see tuberculoid leprosy, skin lesions are single, hypopigmented, and asymmetrical in nature. So one lesion will be different from another lesion. And so the peripheral nerve involvement will be more, and we will observe distinct sensory impairment in case of tuberculoid leprosy. So this is how we will observe the lesions, skin lesions in case of tuberculoid leprosy. And these are all the lesions in case of lepromatous leprosy. And coming to the symptoms, so in case of leprosy, so if you see this tuberculoid leprosy, we will observe pain, severe pain wherever the lesions are. Along with that, we will observe muscle weakness, skin stiffness and dryness, loss of fingers and toes, eye related problems, blindness, enlarged nose will be observed in case of tuberculoid leprosy. And in case of lepromatous leprosy, we will observe thickened skin on the face, nasal stiffness, we will observe bloody nose, laryngitis, collapsing of the nose, swelling of lymph nodes in the groin and armpits area, scarring of the testis that leads to infertility, and enlargement of male breast will be observed in case of lepromatous leprosy. Coming to the diagnostic test, so mostly the diagnosis will be based on the skin smear test and the microscope. So just we have to take some samples of skin lesions or whatever skin lesions, and we have to observe under microscope for the presence of this mycobacterium leprae, as this mycobacterium leprae is as first in nature. एंड वी कैन ऑल्सो गो विथ स्क्रीनिंग टेस्ट का लेप्रोमिन टेस्ट बाय सो बाई इंजेक्टिंग एन इंट्राडर्मल प्यूरिफाइड प्रोटीन डेरिवेटिव ऑफ लेप्रसी इन टू द फोर आर्म. सो जस्ट इट इज़ अ स्क्रीनिंग टेस्ट बट इज़ नॉट अ डायग्नोस्टिक टेस्ट. सो इवन दो इफ यू गेट पॉजिटिव विद दिस लेप्रोमिन टेस्ट यू हैव टू गो विद दिस एग्जामिनेशन अंडर माइक्रोस्कोप. एंड सो दिस पिक्चर विल इज अ रिप्रेजेंटेटिव. सो इट इज़ द लोगो ऑफ So it is the logo of NLEP, National Leprosy Eradication Program, so which was designed by our country in order to eliminate leprosy from India. So this is what the discussion today. So this is the end of the discussion about leprosy.